Chapter 5 Neuro. This is the second of three videos about antidepressants, and in this video we'll be focused on SSRIs. So as you recall from the previous video, SSRI stands for Selective Serotonin Reuptake Inhibitor. So this works by preventing the breakdown of serotonin within neurons. So today we'll be looking at four different drugs in the SSRI class. So we'll start with citalopram, otherwise known as Celexa, escitalopram, otherwise known as Lexapro, sertraline, which is Zoloft, and fluoxetine, which is Prozac. Okay, so practice question number one. An SSRI that can cause dose-dependent QT prolongation is, and so here we have our four options that we'll be working with in this video. So the correct answer is A. So the FDA came out with a warning about QT prolongation. So now there are dose maximums in different patient populations. So the dose maximum in elderly patients is 20 milligrams per day, and in adults it is 40 milligrams per day. With this QT prolongation warning, we want to make sure that we get an electrocardiogram of every patient before we start them on this medication. B, C, and D are incorrect because there is no FDA warning about the QT prolongation with any of these other medications. So for the next few questions, we're going to change the question to make each of the other answers correct. So question three, an SSRI that is an S isomer of a different SSRI is? So the correct answer is B. So escitalopram is the S isomer of citalopram. And as you can recall from the gastrointestinal lectures, omeprazole, and it's kind of like omeprazole and esomeprazole, S is the sinister, more active biological form, and so that is the same thing that escitalopram is to citalopram. So it only takes 10 milligrams of escitalopram, and that's about the equivalent of 20 milligrams of citalopram. So citalopram is incorrect because it contains both the S, the more active S isomer, and the R isomer, and sertraline and fluoxetine don't have any isomers or any other available products with different isomers of those two medications. Question four, make B correct. An SSRI that is one of the safer SSRIs for pregnancy and has harsher GI side effects is, and the answer is C, sertraline. So with sertraline, the GI side effect we especially see, even though they're common in all of the medications, is that this one has quite a bit higher chance of diarrhea. So, and this one also, while a lot of them can be used in pregnancy, this one has historically been pretty common. So A and B are incorrect. They have less severe GI effects than the sertraline. And then D is incorrect because it has fluoxetine. It both has less severe GI effects, and it also, in different studies, has potentially some effects on the baby if used in pregnancy. Question five, an SSRI that can also be used for premenstrual dysmorphic disorder, or PMDD, and has a long half-life, is D, fluoxetine. So A and B are incorrect because there is no premenstrual dysmorphic disorder indication for citalopram or escitalopram. And sertraline is actually indicated for PMDD, but it has a shorter half-life. So fluoxetine is correct because it is indicated for depression and PMDD, and it has a really long half-life. So the way that that works is fluoxetine and its metabolite, they're able to stay in the system longer, which can be good for those who can't remember to take their medication. But since it does linger in the system a little bit longer, if we do switch to a new SSRI, we need to be concerned because the patient will be at higher risk of serotonin syndrome. And so we can remember that fluoxetine is a long-acting medication because it starts with flu, and so fluoxetine is like the flu, and it typically lasts around a week.